This, like all East Anglian towns, is full of nonconformist chapels. The older ones are hidden down alleys. The Plymouth Brethren's meeting house, 1830, with a little graveyard at the back. Gospel simplicity. The Unitarian chapel, down by the edge of the mere, very elegant. It's now a Masonic hall. A bit of New England, here in Norfolk. I should think it was built about 1800. There's the Quaker meeting house, very simple. The Baptists rebuilt themselves in the 1860s, on the other hand, in a very grand manner, sort of Lombardic. And with nonconformity goes thrift. The prosperous merchants of Dis built themselves new houses with large gardens sloping down to the edge of the mere. And there's one right down by the mere itself. Park House, there it is, I should think about 1840. And right at the top of the town, away from Park House, there's Mount Street and this late Georgian door of a lawyer's house. And from it, you can look down a charming country town street, still very like that old photograph there and that one. On the right is Mount Pleasant, the chief house of the town, where Admiral Taylor lived. There's Admiral Taylor welcoming his son. The Admiral's ancestors built this house in the 18th century. They were brewers and Unitarians. Notice the trouble taken about the detail. That dentalled cornice. White paint against red brickwork and the splendid great garden window. And on the other side of Mount Street, do you see that bit of country? It's still the same today. A bit of country coming right into the town. A little park. From the elegant quiet of the professions, let's go down into the town. Into the shops. Look at the chemist there, Goslings. Perfect mid-Victorian. Notice the lamp. The same sort of lamp over the same firm. And that chemist's a Georgian exterior. And here's a draper's shop founded in 1847. Notice the name, Bobby's. It's the same family as all those Bobby's stores on the south coast towns. But they're now part of a big combine, while the Bobby's in Dis still belongs to the family. Look at that woodwork, the mahogany counter, the oak shelves, all about 1850. And there's Mr. Bobby himself. He's been a draper in Dis all his life, as have his father and grandfather before him. Have a look at the detail of that Victorian carving. All this time, there's been something I haven't pointed out to you. It's the kind of thing you come to take for granted. Strolling about in a town like this, the happy inconsequence of everything, the way old houses go well with less old ones, like that one on the left and the one beyond on the right. The sudden glimpse, as you're coming down Denmark Hill, for instance, between two buildings, and you see the mere down below you. And the way gardens look over red-tiled roofs, and how, from the middle of the town, you can look over sharp roofs to the country and the church. and on the whole, an absence of traffic, at any rate of heavy through traffic. Real quiet. The sense of a happy, self-contained, friendly community. Dis. It would be a very nice place to live in. Not too big, not too small, a good train service, and no main road. But look at what's happening. The old houses in the back streets of the town, instead of being repaired, are being allowed to fall to bits. Instead of being enlarged, that's what's happening to them. Some, I grant you, aren't worth preserving. Others are. And you could buy them very cheaply and turn them into comfortable places to live in. It's been done. I mean, look at this row of cottages. They've let them fall to bits on the left here, and then on the right, there's one that's been put into repair. And here are others. They're not right in the centre of the town, but they're very near it, much nearer than the council estate. And look at those. They're the real Dis on the fair green. What you don't want in Dis is copybook contemporary architecture like this. Out of scale, out of texture, and very soon out of date. I mean, look at those real Dis houses and compare them with that thing. And those could just as well be in Slough or Southall. Let's go down to the Mere. Thank you.